Hi children, how are you all? I hope you all are fine, right? Yes, we are the class of which class, Anna? We are the class of
Okay, what is our subject? Science is our subject.
And do you remember the last class what we have discussed about the about different types of plants? And what are the seeds, which plants will produce seeds, which plants will not produce the seeds, like that we have discussed. How many types of plants are there?
Yes, plants are divided into how many types are there?
Two types.
What is the first one?
Yes,
flowering plants. What is the first one?
Flowering plants.
And what is the second one here?
Non-flowering plants.
Yes, non-flowering plants.
We have discussed about the plants which are having the flowers and the non-flowers at all. No flowers at all. And what is the use of the flower here?
Yes,
flowering plants will have seeds.
What is the use here?
Seeds will be there.
What is the use?
Seeds are there.
What is the, what about the non-flowering seeds?
Non-flowering plants?
Yes, there is a no seeds.
No seeds.
Then how they are going to give a new plant?
Yes, we have learned a special character, that is vegetative propagation.
Vegetative propagation.
What is meant by vegetative propagation? We have learned.
Yes, the part of a plant or anything, the part of a plant which is going to give a new plant.
Either the new plant is produced from the stem, roots,
nodes, internodes.
Okay, we have seen different types of plants are getting from the stems, nodes, roots, nodes and internodes. And what is the next one?
Leaves also.
From the leaves also. If we are getting a new plant from the stem or from the root or from the nodes or from the internodes or from the leaves, then we are going to get a new plant. That type of propagation, that type of method is called as a vegetative propagation. Already we have learned in the previous class. And next, after that, what we have learned?
Yes, about the seed.
Flowering plants are, what is the flowering plants are?
Seeds are there.
And how the seeds are going to germinate, we have learned in the first chapter. And next one, the seed. How the seeds are going to spread.
Dispersal.
We have learned about what is meant by seed dispersal.
Means
the seed is going to spread or transfer to one place to another place. It's called a seed dispersal. And we have learned that. Why the seed dispersal is needed? Why, Nana?
Yes, because overcrowded seeds lead to
what happens if the overcrowded seeds are there?
Well, what will happen? No sufficient water.
No sufficient water. Next, what is needed to germinate?
Air.
And next, sunlight. These are the three important things to prepare your food. Now, or to prepare to get a new plant. Seed is going to generate with the help of water, air and sunlight. Already which we have learned in the block one.
Here the overcrowded seeds are there.
What will happen? If the overcrowded, many seeds are in one position, there will be competition between water, competition between air, competition between sunlight. So some seeds may germinate and the remaining seeds may lead to that. That's what we have learned in the previous class. Now today we are going to learn about a seed dispersal, methods of a seed dispersal.
Okay, methods of seed dispersal.
Yes, here is the point. Methods of seed dispersal. What is meant by dispersal here? Already we have learned about the seed and we have learned about the meaning of dispersal. Dispersal means taking to a different place. What is the meaning? Yes, taking to a different place. Taking to a different place. Yes, that is the meaning of the dispenser. Now, what is going to take in a different place? Yes, seeds are going to take a different place. Why we have to need to take in a different place? Yes, to get a new plant in a new place or the new relations, wherever the new region we are going to get. Why it is important? Because if any natural activities or any natural calamities like what we call a earthquake, all these things, if anything will happen, then we have to be safe and secure for the seeds. So what is important here? Dispersal is important, seed dispersal. So we are going to know about methods of the seed dispersal. It is divided into four types. Four types of seed dispersal we are going to see. First one is the wind. Next, water. Next, animals. And explosion. How many types of methods are there? How many methods are there? We are having four types of methods. What is the first one here? Wind. What is the second one here? Yes, water. What is the third one? Animal. And what is the fourth one? Explosion. Here are the four methods of the seed dispersal. We will go in detail with each and every topic. Yes, what is the first one here? Wind. What is meant by wind here? Yes, wind is nothing but air. What we can say? Air. Yes, here is the air. Then what is the main thing of the air? Yes, it has to spread the seeds. Some seeds like, yes, what are the some seeds like the name? Which will fly in the air? Cotton seeds and land. Cotton. Dandelions. These are the two seeds which will fly. How they are going to fly? Yes, these two seeds are having hair or parachutes. Parachutes. Yes, here are the two seeds, cotton and dandelions. Here are the two seeds, like cotton and dandelions, which are having what are the structures on the seed? Yes, they are having the hair-like structure. How we are having the hair? The same way, here are the two seeds, those are cotton and dandelion, which are used to fly with the help of hair or parachute. They will fly with the help of parachute in the air and transfer to a new place and get germinated in a new place. And one more seed is having maple. What is the seed name here? Maple. Maple seeds have wings. We got here three structures. One is the first one is the air, and second one is the parachute, third one is the wings. For wind, how the air is going to transfer or the disperse the seed with the help of hairs of the seed, or with the help of parachutes of the seed, or with the help of wings. Maple is only the special seed which have wings. And cotton seeds, if you observe the cotton seed, everywhere the white color, line-like structure or hair-like structure you can see. That is nothing but the hair. Okay, cotton seed can be fly easily in the air. If you take in the cotton and blow with your hand to a air, then it will blow. And dandelions, we can't see it, but we can see it by the images. It is having parachutes. Normally, we will play a game like that. Devil has seen like that. We can see a seed which has the wings on the seed. Now, I will show you at the end of the story or at the end of the lesson. See here, what are the three seeds we have learned here? Yes. What is the first one? Cotton. What is the second one? Dandelions. What they are having on the body or what they are having on the seed? Yes, they are having hair or parachute. What about the next seed? This is the maple seed. What is having the special character here? Yes, wings it is having. By this we have completed the main topic, that is wind. Wind is going to disperse the seed with the help of hay or with the help of wings or with the help of parachute. Mainly we are having here three types of seeds. First one is the cotton, second one is the dandelions, and third one is the maple. We are having the three seeds in the wind, which are going to spread with the help of the wind, which will flow in the air and transferring it nutrients. Now we are going to see the in the water. How are the water plants? Water plants like hydrilla, water plants like water lily, lotus, and many water plants are going to spread. Not only water plants, remaining plants also will take the help of water to spread their seeds or to disperse their seeds. While water will move from one place to another place in the form of rivers or in the form of oceans, you can see different ways. Water bodies are many. So with the help of air is a natural thing, water is a natural thing, animals also natural thing, and explosion is also natural thing. So who is going to help the seeds to disperse? Yes, nature is help for dispersal of seeds. Who is going to help for the seeds? Yes, nature is going to help for dispersal of seeds. Here, wind is a natural item, and water, as well as animals and exposure. All these are the natural things. So, what we have learned here? Nature. Nature is going to help for the seed dispersal. What is the next thing we have seen here? Water. What are the water plants telling me? Yes, sir. Like water lily, hydrangea, different types of plants which are in our water. They are going to spread seeds with the help of water. Then how they are going to spread? Yes, water is moving in the flow. Flow will be there for the water. Yes or no? Water cannot be stopped at any place. Because it is having a liquid state, it can move from one place to another place. Water like water lily and coconut. Coconut seeds have a special structure that is the fibrous. Fibrous outer covering. Water lily has spongy outer covering. Here I have got two things, two main plants. One is the first one is the water lily. Water lily, you can see it looks like it's same lotus. But water lily's seeds are spongy. Spongy will float on the water, right? Paper will float on the water. Next, goat will float on the water. The same way, sponge is also going to float on the water. What are the next seed? That is coconut. Coconut seed has a special structure that is fibrous outer covering. Fibers. Looks like a very, very, very thin line. Okay, if you are going to cut the coconut also, you can see that is one piece. Piece and not. That is known as the fibers. Here the sponge-like structure. Almost all the water bodies are the almost all water plants having spongy stem, spongy leaves. Everywhere you can see this is spongy structure. Outer covering of the seed is having spongy structure in water lily. But whereas the coconut, what is there? Fibrous outer covering is there, which helps to float in the water. What is the main thing here? To float in the water. Floating water. That is the main thing for water. And what about the animals? What are the animals you can see here? Yes, animals are of different types. Some are of the birds. Yes, birds are also going to eat different types of fruits, different types of seeds. Right? Yes, birds will eat the fruits and carry the fruits or carry the seeds and spread to the different places. The same way, animals also will eat the different types of seeds or different types of fruits, which leads to the dispersal of seeds. Here we are going to see what are the two different types of seeds. Blackberries, and apples. These are the two special fruits or special seeds which are carried by the animals. How they are going to carry? Yes, animals are going to eat the fruit as well as a food like fruits, vegetables, seeds. So by the waste of their like fecus. How they are going to live? With the fecus. Fecus is nothing but waste metal which is from the bone. So from the fecus, which are the two things we are going to get? Seeds, blackberries as well as apples. These are the two seeds
from the fecus of different animals, we are going to collect in different places. It is laid through the spread or the dispersal of a seed. Next, some seeds like the bark, yes, here are the some seeds. Some seeds are having bark. What is mean by bark? A short structure. What is the short structure? Why it is needed? Yes, it is going to touch the body of animal and it is going to stuck like this. How I am going to stuck the chopsticks to my body? The same way bark seeds are going to stuck. Or the bark is one of the main character of the seed to stuck to the body or to stick to the body. And xanthan is having the hooks. Xanthan seed is having hooks. Either if any seed having hooks or any seed having shaft, which are helpful to stick to the body and spread to the different places where the plant, where the animals or the birds are going. In this way, the seeds are dispersed from one place to another place. What are the two plants or the two seeds we spread with the help of the fecus of animals? Blackberries and apples. These are the two fruits which are eaten mostly by the all types of animals and carried in their body and used them somewhere with the help of their fecus. And next here is the one more short body, that is the bark. Sharp pointed grain. It is helpful to stick to the body and helpful to move from one place to another place. Xanthan having the hooks. So it has to be carried with the help of animals. Okay, now we are going for the extrusion. What is meant by extrusion here? Yes, blast or the, yes, it is going to blast. You can say blast also. Blast or blast. Explosion. If the seed or if the fruit is going to be ripened, when the seeds are going to ripen, those seeds are going to be blast. Yes or no? If some seeds having many seeds inside, like pomegranate, you can see many seeds. Watermelon having many seeds. If almost everywhere you can see some types of seeds are having many, some fruits are having many seeds. So to spread the seeds, what they are going to do? Yes, they are going to blast the outer coat or blast the fruit to spread the seeds in different places. We can see mostly peas and beans. Yes. Pea structure will be collected. Yes, in the middle you can see the peas or the beans will be inside of a seed coat or inside of a shell. Right? If they are ripened, then they are going to blast. And the outer part, seed coat is being removed. Then the seeds are going to spread. These are the two seeds, peas and beans are the two seeds which are going to blast with the help of explosion. It will be seen. Now we have learned about water. What is the main thing of the water here? Floating the seeds in water. Wind carrying them with the help of their tail and parachutes. What about the animals here? Animals are carrying with the help of their bodies or with the help of their fetus. Here, explosion, mainly the force of the seed or force of a fruit is going to be blast when it has ripened. Examples are pea and beans. Now I am going to show you the pictures of okay, first picture, seed dispersal with the wind. Okay, see here in the wind, how the seed is going to disperse. You can see the main strand from that, the seeds are going to out. How they are, yes, they are having hair-like structures on the body. So they are going to fly in the air. Some seeds are having the parachute. Some seeds are having wings. Plants which will grow, which will carried by the wind, are having what are their three structures? Hair-like structure, parachute-like structure, and wing-like structures. The seed dispersed with the wind. You can see the white color hair-like structure that is carried by the wind. Okay, we will move to the next picture. Daniel seeds. Now, from the flower, how the seeds are spreading? You can see how they are flying. They are having the wing-like structure. It is called as a parachute. Especially, it is only for this seed. Dandelion seed is having a special structure
that is the parachute, which helps to fly. Next, we will move to the next picture. Maple seed. Maple seed having, yes, wings. You can see the, below the seed you can see the leaf-like structure or the wing-like structure. It helps to fly in the air. Okay, next. We are going with the seeds with the barbs. See the tiny hair-like structure or tiny pointed-like, short-like structure, which are going to stick to the animal body and helps the animal to carry with them for a long distance, and which leads to the dispersal of a seed. What is the meaning of the barb here? Yes, sharp pointed grains or sharp pointed seeds. Next, animal carry the seeds away. You can see the next picture. Squirrel is going to eat the food, or squirrel is going to eat the seeds. If the seeds are eaten by the squirrel, squirrel will not be only on one plant, right? Yes, it will move from one place to another place. In that way, the squirrel is going to carry the seeds with it, as well as with the help of its beakers also, some of the seeds are going to transfer, or some of the seeds are going to disperse from one place to other place. Next one, you can see one ball-like structure, and inside the seeds are coming out. It is the plant of pea. Peas and beans are, I told you, yes, explosion. That is a picture of explosion. Explosion in pods. In that, if the ripen, already the fruit is or the seed is ripened, then they are going to blossom. From that, the seeds are going to disperse, or the seeds are going to transfer from one place to other place with the help of the wind or with the help of the force. Okay, you can see the picture, how they are coming out. In the second, it was closed one, and in the first one, it has been opened. You can see that. By this, we have completed the topic regarding, yes, seeds have dispersed. Methods of seed dispersal. In how many ways we have dispersed the seeds? Four ways. What is the first one? Wind. And what is the second one? Water. And what is the third one? Animal. What is the fourth one? Explosion. By this, we have learned about the explosion of the, learned about methods of seed dispersal. And what is the use of the seed dispersal here? Yes, it helps to spread the seeds from different places, and it helps the seed to get water, air, sunlight sufficiently. As well as the next thing, what is that? Yes, if any natural calamities like earthquake, floods, volcano eruption, those can be survived because wind can be carried to the different place, the seed, and the water can be carried to the different place of the where the mother plant is. Some seeds are with the mother plant, so they may die if the natural calamity is. If they are transferred, if they are dispersed to the different place, they are going to allow. So it leads to the spread of the seeds variety, and as well as it helps us to give the species for the next generation. This is our topic regarding methods of seed dispersal. By this, we have completed our topic. Okay, children, please try to complete the worksheet, and we will meet in the next class. Be healthy, be happy.